was your favorite baddie. You know, he was doable as a bad guy.
It either scares you or it thrills you.
I find your lack of faith disturbing.
And there was something chilling about that breathing noise.
Episode 3 ultimately is the story about how does Anakin Skywalker become Darth Vader, and I think that's the story that everybody has been waiting for.
This is the beginning of the end for Anakin.
You don't know the power of the dark side.
Part of the reason I went back to tell the prequel of how Anakin Skywalker became Darth Vader is that it's an interesting story, and it's a fun story to tell because it is the story of how a good person turns bad. You know, he progresses from being a bright, smart, loving, caring young boy to being an attentive, hardworking, but ambitious Padawan learner who feels that because he's better at his being a Jedi and his Jedi skills than most of the other Jedi, that he should progress further and faster.
In some ways, a lot of ways, I'm really ahead of him.
And as he progressed, it was his inability to control his temper, his greed to control things, that were his undoing.
His whole slide to the dark side is quite carefully done, and it comes from very human things that he's in love, you know, and that he's going to be a father, and that he's jealous, and I don't know, we've all done it, messed things up because we're young and naive and not able to step back and go, oh no, it's okay.
Put the ship down!
Anakin! Don't let your personal feelings get in the way!
The problem that Anakin has in this whole thing is he has a hard time letting go of things.
I don't want things to change.
But you can't stop the change.
As he sought more and more power to try to change people's fate so that they're the way he wants them, that greed goes from trying to save the one you love to realizing you can control the universe. There was this missing piece now of episode 3, and that is the key missing piece of episode 3, which everybody's always wanted to see, which is the return of Anakin Skywalker in the suit. The face, the design, the early Ralph McQuarrie inspiration is still there, and we've tried to remain faithful to that.
As we looked at the original helmet, we've noticed that it's not a symmetrical shape. It was an opportunity for us to make it more symmetrical, and that's what we're trying to do.
So this is the bit where all the detail needs to be. So we've spent a long time getting this side beautiful. I scanned it into my machine, and then I flipped it in the computer, and then I'm just cutting the right-hand side. Hopefully by the end of the day, we'll have the other half of that we can put together and see what it looks like. And that'll be the first time we've seen a symmetrical Darth Vader. We've got the beginning of the helmet. That's going to go into a mold tomorrow. We've got the shoulders. We're starting on the head. All of these pieces in the next couple of weeks are going to start coming together and become Darth Vader, which is great, but we still have to do the boxes. We have to start doing fittings.
It originally starts out as just this beige suit, which isn't very intimidating at all. But, you know, I still got this sensation of nostalgia that I wasn't aware what I was going to feel.
I've been waiting for you, Obi-Wan. We meet again at last.
And they could have just put some really tall guy in it and got away with it, but I begged and pleaded, and they were nice enough to build a Darth Vader suit that actually fit me.
When we put this helmet on before, it just looked too thin. In here, I don't know if you can really see it, but by actually adding a little bit of the pipe there and by adding a bit in there, it just builds it all out and it fills in the face, and it's much more what we're used to seeing. So it's really weird things like that that we're just discovering all the time, things that we thought we'd be beyond by now.
Simultaneously, we had to create a sequence where both Anakin and Obi-Wan were going to fight with each other. This is a really difficult thing. This is best friends. You know, this is a mentor and his teacher, and their relationship falls apart, and Anakin allows this to happen.
Obi-Wan seems always to have been a little wary of this child, and having made a promise to his dying master, Qui-Gon, he promises to turn this wee kid into a Jedi and look after him, which he does, I think, to the best of his ability.
In the sword fighting, you have to learn 1,000 moves. It's very hard, and you have to memorize them. And you really have to memorize them well, or you get hit in the head.
Whoa, fingers!
The repetition of having to do each sequence over and over again and trying to get it so that it is as perfect as we could get it to be was exhausting.
We have to do that one again. Can't leave it at that.
Hard work, but really satisfying, I suppose, at the end of the day.
The guys would get so into it, and then one of them make a mistake, boom, break, they would be fine, laughing, everything else, and then boom, seconds later, they were back into it. And this would go on for hours and hours every day.
Ewan has always been a great sword fighter, but Hayden is very athletic, and he's also very good at it. The difference in this particular one is they have to fight each other. So we got some very, very good performances there, you know, working their routines through and trying to be better than the other guy.
And that leads into this.
They've done more layers of the silicone, and then we've done a fiberglass jacket around it. We've then taken all of that off so we could get the original shape out. So we now have an empty shell, which is going to be our Darth Vader helmet, which now Adam is about to start laying up in polyester, in fiberglass.
That looks fairly good.
I think that must be incredibly exciting for Hayden, being Darth Vader.
Getting into Darth Vader, that's the cool part.
One more fitting with Hayden and then filming on him. And it'll be just a memory. Everyone on the crew, everyone on my crew, wanted to be involved in this. The day we were on set with him, and then he came into shot, and you saw him shining as he went up, you just thought, that is an amazing thing.
Takes us back to the old days.